Yo guys! So a common misconception that I always hear is that if you have a 60Hz monitor and your graphics card is pushing out more than 60fps, that you're just wasting computational energy because you're not going to notice a difference. So it is true, if you have a monitor that's 60Hz, that you can only see 60 full frames per second. Now let's say your graphics card is pushing out 100 frames per second. You will see more than 60 frames per second. And that's because on every cycle refresh of your monitor, you're going to be seeing a frame and a half. So you won't be seeing a full frame, you'll be seeing a frame and half another frame. So this creates what many people call as tearing. So getting back to the main point, if you ever hear someone claim that getting an FPS that's more than their monitor's refresh rate feels smoother, well, they're not crazy. It actually makes sense, and here's why. So picture this. Your graphics card outputs exactly 60 frames per second, and you have a monitor that's exactly 60Hz. Now, keep in mind, your graphics card and your monitor do not update at the same time. So your monitor works in the cycle and it waits for the next frame available to display. Now let's just say, between waiting for the next update, you do some crazy action. Well, your monitor might not get that frame immediately because it's on a cycle. Oh, one way to alleviate this whole situation is if you have your monitor and graphics card update at the same time. And this is what VSync does. Now, any gamer basically knows to turn off VSync because VSync creates horrible input lag. It basically forces your monitor to update in a set interval of 30 or 60 FPS, which will create lots of drop frames in between. Now, there are other sync solutions that help when your FPS goes over your monitor refresh rate. There's VSync, there's G-Sync, and there's FreeSync. And G-Sync and FreeSync work better than VSync, but they all have their different variations and they all have their pros and cons. But let's take all the syncing out of the equation. And let's just say, all right, we're going to uncap your FPS. We're going to keep it running at 100 FPS on your 60Hz monitor. Well, now, going back to the chart, when your monitor refreshes to the next cycle, if you do an action in between that refresh, you could possibly still see the action on the next update because there are more frames to pull from. You're getting a frame and half another frame. And this happens so quickly that you might not even notice a tearing happening within the gameplay. So this is how getting a large FPS that's more than your refresh rate can feel smoother because in reality, your monitor has more frames to choose from. So guys, if someone tells you that going over your monitor refresh rate is just a waste of computational energy, tell them that they are wrong because it actually does make a small difference. So guys, if you liked this video, definitely give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to go and follow me on social media. And as always, thanks for watching and stay tuned for another galvanizing video.